Hello everybody, Martin here, and welcome to my second course here at cgboost.com. For over 10 years now, I've been exploring this wonderful world of 3D graphics. I've worked on visual effects for movies, I made some cinematics for games, and also my fair share of personal projects. And now, I've got a confession to make. For many months, I've been obsessed with 3D environments. Large-scale 3D environments in Blender, to be precise. I went through hours of tutorials, I bought courses, I studied books about erosion, about different biomes and terrains, and all the while I was trying to achieve that one goal: believable 3D environments directly in Blender. I really wanted to prove that you do not actually need any expensive software to achieve results like this. This course is the culmination of my research. In it, you will learn how to put together mountains and lakes, deserts and forests, clouds and oceans, all directly in Blender, using free tools and resources. The workflows I show are step by step, though I definitely expect you to know your way around Blender, so it might be a good idea to finish up Zach's Blender Launchpad course first. You can go step by step, preparing your own research and studying various environment types in Chapter 2, and then get an overall idea of the methods at your disposal in the third chapter. After that, you can jump into trying out your first workflows with either a mesh creation approach from Chapter 4 or with various node-based methods from Chapters 5 to 7. Deserts and mountains, that's what's expecting you there. You can learn about directly displacing your geometry through modifiers in Chapter 8 or generating your landscapes from satellite data in Chapter 9. After that, it is all about specific environment breakdowns, usually just combining methods you will have already learned in the first several chapters. At the end of the course, you will be able to dive into specifics, making your own assets, generating 2D cards with trees and other flora, making various types of water surfaces, and of course, it wouldn't be an environment course without clouds. Finally, since Blender is well known for its amazing add-ons that boost productivity and save time, I will introduce those that I use regularly. Those are of course paid products, so this chapter is a bonus, not really something you have to rely upon in the course. Nevertheless, you can approach this course also completely differently, like a buffet of sorts. Learn what you need, discard what you don't, and then later come back again and learn something completely different. After completing all the chapters in this course, you will have a solid foundation for creating your own awesome looking environments directly in Blender. Okay, my friends, I hope you're excited. And now get yourself a map, mountain boots, swimming suit, desert hat, and prepare to make some large-scale landscape awesomeness. You don't really need all those things, just Blender, really. Let's do it.